Roma is the newest film from one of the greatest living directors, Alfonso Cuarón. It's about a maid living in Mexico in the 1970s, but no plot summary can do justice to this incredible poetic movie. Cuarón is mostly known for critically acclaimed films like Children of Men and Gravity, but don't go in expecting an experience anything like either of those. This is a much more personal film for the director, as it was inspired by his nanny, and there's nothing even remotely resembling an action sequence. The main selling point here is undoubtedly the stunning black-and-white cinematography, which unusually Cuarón was in charge of himself. Shot digitally on an Alexa 65, it's the best-looking film of 2018 I've seen and should be a lock for the Best Cinematography Oscar. Roma is mostly filmed in wide shots with few close-ups. Cuarón's camera serves as an impartial observer that just takes everything in with slow pans and tracking shots. He stated he wanted to avoid subjective camera moves like dollies in and out and wanted it to feel aloof and distant. Despite the camera's distance, Roma somehow still feels intimate. This will come to Netflix soon, but I highly recommend taking in these beautiful images in a theater since this is one of the best shot black and white films I've ever seen. The film is pretty much flawless in all technical aspects, with the immersive sound design also standing out and doing plenty of heavy lifting considering there's no music. The lack of music is certainly a bold choice, and I think music may have made the film feel more artificial. Roma's plot is quite simple, and some who aren't as used to more artsy movies might call this a film where nothing happens. But it's not a plot-driven film. It's about characters and an environment, both portrayed perfectly. The acting is brilliant all around, and everyone comes off as if they aren't even acting. A massive amount of credit has to go to the lead, Yalitza Aparicio, who, despite literally never acting before in her life, gives an understated yet Oscar-worthy performance. Roma is far from a short film with its 2-hour and 15-minute runtime, and it certainly takes its time in certain parts, but this doesn't detract from the movie at all. Cuarón's film is overall quite serious and at times depressing, with just a few moments of slight humor. I don't think this is quite as good as Children of Men or Gravity, but it's hard to compare since the films are so different, and I'm sure many will disagree. However, don't get the impression this is anything less than a masterpiece, and anyone into indie or artistic filmmaking should see this as soon as possible. It's easily one of the top films of the year. The critics seem to agree, as it has an almost perfect 99% on Rotten Tomatoes. It also has a 95 on Metacritic, the highest of any film this year. Roma will surely be a juggernaut at the Oscars as well, with many technical nominations being likely. It's also a sure thing to get nods in Best Picture, Best Director, and Best Original Screenplay. And of course, Aparicio has a good chance of getting a nomination as well. Roma is coming out in theaters November 21st and will be available to stream on Netflix December 14th. That's all for this review. Please don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.